We are living in a time of the biodiversity crisis. So we lose species everywhere. And one of the species' richest environments are rainforests.
Have you ever wondered where we come from? And where life is going? The Museum for Naturkunde Berlin has the answers. We are reinventing ourselves for a better future. Join us. Become part of our museum evolution.
My name is Carla Neira Salamea, and I am an Ecuadorian PhD student at the Rudels Lab. And my study focuses on the reassembly of predator prey networks, leaf litter frogs, and the arthropods that constitute their diet.
A lot of people have already investigated if rainforests are able to regenerate. So from a degraded state where trees have been harvested to a more or less original state. In the REASSEMBLY project, we are investigating a particular topic which was so far neglected. We do not only want to know if along a gradient from completely destroyed to primary rainforest species re-establish on the plots, we also want to know if species interactions are coming back. Interactions may be pollination or seed dispersal or, in our project, predator-prey relationships.
The first challenge is to go to these areas because some of them are far away from the station. All the processing of the frogs is done in situ. So we set up the camp and then we search for frogs. We catch every frog we see, and after a period of time, we start processing them.
We are investigating what frogs are eating, and we are particularly interested in knowing if frogs who are eating everything, like most species, and species which need a particular prey item, react differently in their ability to come back in degraded habitats.
First, we identify the species, then we take body measurements, we identify the age class and sex, and then we start with the stomach flushing. So we literally flush water inside the frog's stomach in order to get the stomach content. Of course, the frogs don't like it very much, but at the end they are all released unharmed in the same forest. The genus Pristi mantis, it's not that popular because they are considered small brownish frogs, but actually they are really interesting because it is the biggest genus of vertebrates in the world. And they are so similar between each other that it's complicated to differentiate between them. And there is also a high amount of diversity that hasn't been discovered yet. Poison dart frogs, on the other hand, are popular not only because they are colorful, they are beautiful, they are bright, but because they contain alkaloids that they use to protect themselves, but also, for example, indigenous peoples use for hunting. After this field season, I will start analyzing my data, and I hope we will find interesting results and that we will be able to better understand the processes in the forest, the restoration of interaction networks, the changes of the frogs communities, and especially to contribute to the conservation of this forest.